The Gospel of John, chapter 3, verses 3 to 5. Jesus answered, "In truth I tell you, no one can see the kingdom of God without being born from above." Nicodemus said, "How can anyone who is already old be born? Is it possible to go back into the womb again and be born?" Jesus replied, "In truth I tell you, no one can enter the kingdom of God without being born through water and spirit." This is the word of the Lord. Grace and peace, my dear brothers and sisters. Yesterday we have gone through the commandments. And again, we will go through the various sins in the Bible. Apart from the commandments, there are various sins. And very often we neglect many of these things. But when we hear the word of God, God will reveal many things to us in our life too. We all need correction every day, because we are on the way to eternal life. Philippians chapter 3 verses 12 to 14, as St. Paul says, I haven't yet reached, but I am going towards that finishing point. Philippians chapter 3, verses 12 to 14. We'll listen to that word.
Not that I have secured it already.
So none of us can say, "I have reached," or "I have secured. I'm already in the heaven." No one can say. But we are all in the process.
Nor yet reached my goal.
Not yet reached my goal.
But I am still pursuing it, in the attempt to take hold of the prize for which Christ Jesus took hold of me.
Yes, our Lord has prepared something for us, an eternal prize.
Brothers, I do not reckon myself as having taken hold of it. I can only say that forgetting all that lies behind
me. As St. Paul says, forgetting all
that lies behind me.
That lies behind it, I am.
And straining forward to what lies in front.
Yes, I am straining forward what lies ahead. So this is what our life should be. Whatever mistake we have done, that is our past. Confess. And again, lead a new life. Galatians chapter 6 verse 15. It is very important to be a new creation.
It is not being circumcised or uncircumcised
that
matters.
Nothing external, but internal. That's what the word of God meant.
But what matters is a new creation.
What matters is a new creation. That is what our Lord is inviting each one of us to be, to become a new creation. Change of heart. It will happen when we surrender our life to our Lord, when we confess our sins to our Lord. So we should confess from the heart. That's what St. John says in 1 John chapter 1 verses 8 to 10. We have already read that yesterday. If you confess your sins, if you acknowledge and confess your sins, you will experience His great mercy. So let us confess our sins. Let us find out where I have failed, where I have to correct, and take the steps and ask our Lord to teach us. John chapter 14 verse 26 and John chapter 15 verse 26, the Holy Spirit will remind us what to do, how to do. Even we don't know how to pray, but Holy Spirit will teach us to pray according to the will of God. Romans chapter 8, verses 26 and 27. Our Lord will teach us. That's what our Lord, Psalms 94, verse 12 says,
How blessed are those you instruct, Yahweh.
How blessed are those who are trained by our Lord.
Whom you teach by the means of your law.
You teach by
the means of your law.
Means of your law. This is good. Our Lord, wants to teach something to each one of us. We are not teaching. Our Lord is teaching. That's what the word of God says. Matthew chapter 10, verses 19 and 20. Sometimes we may wonder how this word of God is coming. It is a spirit. Matthew chapter 10, verses 19 and 20.
But when you are handed over, do not worry about how to speak or what to say.
Do not worry about how to speak or what to say.
What you are to say, will be given to you when the time comes.
Yes, and the time come, whatever we need, each soul, whatever we need, the Holy Spirit will give.
Because it is not you who will be speaking, the Spirit of your Father will be speaking in you.
Yes, it is the Spirit of the Father is speaking. That's why we all should be in prayer. When we are in prayer, our Lord will speak to us personally. Isaiah chapter 30, verses 20 and 21. We will hear the voice. This is the way, keep to it. Isaiah chapter 30, verses 20 and 21.
When the Lord has given you the bread of suffering and the water of distress, he who is your teacher will hide no longer.
That is the very reason our Lord is allowing us to go through the trials. When the trials come, we will learn many things. James chapter 1, verses 2 to 8. The test and trials are good for our soul.
And you will see your teacher with your own eyes.
Yes.
Your ears will hear these words behind you. This is the way. Keep to it.
This is the way. Keep to it.
Whether you turn to right or left.
So we all should listen to that voice from our good Lord. Our Lord wants to speak something to each one of us. Listen to it and follow his steps. Our Lord will guide us. Psalm 25 verses 9 to 12. Those who fear him, our Lord will show us the way. And John 14 verse 6 says, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. So our Lord will show the way to eternal life. So let us tune our ears to listen to his word. Proverbs chapter 2, verses 3 and 4.
Yes, if your plea is for clear perception, if you cry out for understanding.
Proverbs 2, verses 1 to 4, you can read. Proverbs chapter 2, verses 1 to 4.
My child, if you take my words to heart, if you set store by my commandments, tuning your ear to wisdom.
Yes, we should tune our ears for wisdom. Tuning your ears for wisdom.
Tuning your heart to understanding.
And tuning our hearts for understanding. Whenever we listen to the word of God, we should tune. Normally we tune our radio to listen to some station. So our Lord wants to speak to each one of us, we should tune. And the moment our Lord will speak.
Yes, if your plea is for clear perception, if you cry out for understanding, if you look for it as though for silver, search for it as though for buried treasure, then you will understand what the fear of Yahweh is and discover the knowledge of God.
You will understand what the fear of Yahweh is and discover the knowledge of God. We will get understanding and the knowledge. So, and also we should pray for the Holy Spirit. John chapter 16, verses 8. When the Holy Spirit comes, the Holy Spirit will remind us what we are, what really we are. John 16 verse 8.
And when he comes, he will show the world how wrong it was.
And he will show the world how wrong
it was.
Yeah, only the Holy Spirit can show how wrong we are. Till that time we may be thinking we are good. But again, Samit says in Psalm 19 verses 12 to 14, that's a beautiful prayer for Samit. Who can dictate his own failings? How can we dictate our own failings? Someone has to tell. So that's what Psalm says, Psalm 19 verses 12 to 14.
But who can detect his own failings? Wash away my hidden faults.
Yeah, wash away my hidden faults. We all have hidden faults, hidden sins. But when the word of God comes in us, everything will come out. Because word of God is powerful. Nothing is hidden from the word of God. Hebrews chapter 4 verses 12 and 13. So we will complete this Psalm 19 verses 12 to 14.
And from pride preserve your servants.
Yes. And from pride preserve your servants.
Never let it be my master.
Never let it be my master. We are coming to that. There are seven capital sins. And the first one is pride. So we all should pray, never pride be my master. That's what Psalmist is praying. That can you repeat that word again?
And from pride preserve your servant.
From pride preserve your servant.
Never let it be my master.
Never let it be my master. It is very easy to deviate from our Lord. A moment is enough. Even the disciples, they were walking with Jesus, and Jesus sent them out to perform some miracles. Luke chapter 10, verses 17 to 20. And they went out, and they did some mission work, and they came back to the Lord and said, Lord, read that.
The 72 came back rejoicing.
They have great joy because,
Lord, they said, even the devils submit to us when we use your name.
And they said, even devil come and submit to us even we use your name. They are saying devil is coming and surrendering us. But in fact, devil surrendered in the name of Jesus, not to them. But the moment when the miracle happened, the pride came in their mind. So then immediately Jesus warned them.
He said to them, I watched Satan fall like lightning from heaven.
I watched Satan falling from heaven like the lightning. A moment is enough for the pride.
Look, I have given you power to tread down serpents and scorpions. And
even if I have given all the power.
And the whole strength of the enemy. Nothing shall ever hurt you.
Yes.
Yet do not rejoice that the spirits submit to you.
Do not rejoice when the spirits submit to you.
Rejoice instead that your names are written in heaven.
Rejoice instead your name has written in the heaven. It's a free gift from our Lord. Nothing to be proud of. But give glory to God. Luke chapter 17 verse 10. That's why when we say, something happened, we should give all glory to our Lord.
So with you, when you have done all you have been told to do, say, we are useless servants.
We are useless servants.
We have done no more than our duty.
We have done no more than our duty. This is what we should do, my dear brothers and sisters. Otherwise, the pride will come and we will deviate from the faith. And many have fallen because of this pride. And we know, as we know, the beginning of Satan is from the pride. Isaiah chapter 14, verses 9 to 14. Who was he? He was one of the angels in the heaven. Because of his pride, he wanted to become higher than our Lord. Isaiah chapter 14, verses 9 to 14.
On your account, Sheol below is astir to greet your arrival. He has roused the ghosts to greet you, all the rulers of the world. He has made all the kings of the nations get up from their thrones. They will all greet you with the words, so, you too are now as weak as we are. You too have become like us. Your pride has been flung down to Sheol.
Yes, your pride has been flung down to Sheol.
With the music of your lyres.
Yes.
Under you a mattress of maggots. Over you a blanket of worms. How did you come to fall from the heavens?
And the word of God is asking, how did you came down from heaven?
Destar, son of dawn, how did you come to be thrown to the ground, conqueror of nations? You who used to think to yourself, I shall scale the heavens.
And I came there. He used to think himself,
I shall scale the heavens.
I shall scale heaven. Let's listen. How many times I.
Higher than the stars of God, I shall set my throne.
I shall set my throne.
I shall sit on the mount.
I shall sit on the mount of assembly.
Far away to the north. I shall climb high above the clouds.
I shall climb high above the clouds.
I shall rival the Most High.
I shall rival the Most High. Then what happened?
Now you have been flung down to Sheol.
Because of his pride, God thrown him out. Revelation chapter 7, Revelation chapter 12, verses 7 to 10.
And now war broke out in heaven when Michael with his angels attacked the dragon. The dragon fought back with his angels, but they were defeated and driven out of heaven. The great dragon, the primeval serpent, known as the devil or Satan, who had led all the world astray, was hurled down to the earth, and his angels were hurled down with him. Then I heard a voice shout from heaven, salvation and power and empire have forever have been won by our God, and all authority for his Christ now that the accuser who accused our brothers day and night before our God has been brought down.
Yes, the great dragon, the pestilent serpent known as devil or Satan, who had led all the world astray, was hurled down to the earth, and his angels were hurled down with him. Satan and his angels came into the world. So this is what the pride. So that's why the book of Sirach says, Sirach chapter 10, verses 9 to 16, because of pride, many have gone astray from the Lord.
What has dust and ashes to pride itself on? Even in life, its entrails are repellent. A long illness makes a fool of the doctor.
You can write from 6 to 18. Sirach chapter 10, verses 6 to 18. We'll continue reading this.
A long illness makes a fool of the doctor. A king today is a corpse tomorrow. For in death, the portion of all alike will be insects, wild animals, and worms. The first stage of pride is to desert the Lord.
The first stage of pride is to desert the Lord.
And to turn one's heart away from one's Maker. Since the first stage of pride is sin, whoever clings to it will pour forth filth.
And with pride, all the sins will be there.
This is why the Lord inflicts unexpected punishments on such people, utterly destroying them. The Lord has turned mighty princes off their thrones and seated the humble there instead. The Lord has plucked up the proud by the roots and planted the lowly in their place. The Lord has overthrown the lands of the nations and destroyed them to the very foundations of the earth. Sometimes he has taken them away and destroyed them and blotted out their memory from the earth.
That's why the book of Sirach chapter 3 verse 18 says, the greater you are, the more humbly you should behave, and then you will find favor with the Lord. So through the humility, we should conquer pride. That is what Jesus did in Philippians chapter 2, verses 1 to 11. Jesus did not count equality with God something to be grasped, but he emptied himself, taking the form of a slave. He became like as a human being. He became like a slave. And through that, we are rescued. Through the power of the humility. So in our life too, we should humble ourselves so that we can conquer the evil pride. So we should never be mastered by pride. So let us take the armor of humility. Daniel chapter 10 verse 12. The moment when we mortify ourselves, God spoke to prophet Daniel.
He then said, Daniel, do not be afraid. From that first day when, the better to understand, you resolved to mortify yourself before God, your words have been heard.
Your words have been heard. When we humble ourselves, our prayer will reach in front of the Lord. So humility is a great virtue against pride. So then we'll go through the capital sins. Pride, then avarice, greed. Colossians chapter 3 verse 5, greed is an idol worship.
That is why you must kill everything in you that is earthly: sexual vice, impurity, uncontrolled passion, evil desires, and especially greed, which is the same thing as worshipping a false god.
Same thing as worshipping a false god, greed. So that's why our heart always should put into the Lord. Matthew chapter 6 verses 19 to 24. We should store treasures in the heaven. And Matthew 6 24 says,
no one can be the slave of two masters. He will either hate the first and love the second, or be attached to the first and despise the second.
And Matthew 6 21. Matthew 6, 21 says, for wherever your treasure is, there your heart
will be
too. So we all should put our treasure in the Lord. Because earth, whatever is in the earth, everything will pass away. Isaiah chapter 40, verses 6 to 8. Our life is like a grass. Isaiah 40, verses 6 to 8.
a voice said, "Cry aloud." And I said, "What shall I cry? All humanity is grass.
All humanity is grass.
And all its beauty like the wild
flowers.
What a
beauty we have. Everything will disappear today or tomorrow.
The grass withers, the flower fades. When the breath of Yahweh blows on them, the grass is surely the people. The grass withers, the flower fades, but the word of our God remains forever."
But the word of our Lord remains forever. So we should realize that even if we live 100 years, that is like a drop of water in the sea, if you compare with eternal life. Sirach chapter 18, verses 8 to 12. You can write this word and you can read it later. Our life is short, and we all should die sooner or later. We have to say goodbye to everyone. So remember, never put our trust in this world, but put our trust in the Lord. Our Lord will provide everything. That's why Hebrews chapter 13, verse 5 says, our life should be,
"Put avarice out of your lives and be content with whatever you have."
Yes. Satisfy whatever you have in your life. And Lord will never abandon you. And Lord knows what we need. 1 Peter chapter 5. Verses 6 and 7.
"Bow down then before the power of God now, so that he may raise you up in due time."
And again, 1 Timothy chapter 6, verses 6 to 10 says, the love of money is the root of all the evil. If you put our trust, some people we can see, they put their trust in money, wealth, or many other things. It cannot be with them forever. That's why we put our trust in the Lord.
The love of money is the root of all evils. And there are some who, pursuing it, have wandered away from the faith and so given their souls...
Many have wandered away from the faith because of the love of money.
And so given their souls any number of fatal wounds.
Yes.
But as someone dedicated to God, avoid all that. You must aim to be upright and religious.
That's why book of Proverbs chapter 15, verses 16 and 17 says,
"Better to have little and with it fear of Yahweh than immense wealth and with it anxiety. Better a dish of herbs when love is there than a fattened ox and hatred to go with it."
Yes, better to have something little with our Lord. Proverbs chapter 30, verses 6 and 7, a beautiful prayer.
"To his words make no addition, lest he reprove you and account you a liar. Two things I beg of you." "Do not grudge me them before I die. Keep falsehood and lies far from me. Give me neither poverty nor riches. Grant me only my share."
Give neither poverty nor riches.
"Grant me only my share of food."
Yes.
"For fear that surrounded by plenty, I shall fall away and say, Yahweh."
I shall fall away from the Lord if the riches come in our life.
And say, "Yahweh, who is Yahweh? Or else in destitution take to stealing and profane the name of my God."
And that's why Jesus says in Matthew chapter 6, verses 25 to 34, "Do not worry about tomorrow." That's why I'm telling you, not to worry about your life and what you are to eat, nor about the body, what you are to wear. Surely life is more than food and the body more than clothing. And again, 33 and 34 says, "Set your hearts on his kingdom first and God's saving justice, and all these other things will be given to you as well. So do not worry about tomorrow. Tomorrow will take care of itself. Each day has enough trouble of its own." Do not worry about tomorrow. Put the trust in the Lord. Psalm 125 verse 1. Those who put trust in the Lord are like Mount Zion. This is the trust we need in our life, my dear brothers and sisters. Never put our trust in the worldly things. And that will not be with us forever. So we should conquer that evil greed with practice of liberty. And again, the third capital sin is envy or jealousy. Proverbs chapter 14, verse 30 says,
"The life of the body is a tranquil heart, But envy is a cancer in the bones.
Envy is like a cancer
in the bones.
So jealousy, envy comes in our life, we'll lose all our grace. So that's why we should pray, and we should be generous, and we should pray for practice brotherly love. Love can conquer all the evil. 1 Peter chapter 4 verse 8.
Above all, preserve an intense love for each other, since love covers over many a sin.
Yes, love covers many a sin. And again, St. Peter says in 1 Peter chapter 3, verses 1 to 3.
In the same way, you wives should be obedient to your husbands.
1 Peter chapter 2, verses 1 to 3. 1 Peter chapter 2, verses 1 to 3.
Rid yourselves then of all spite, deceit, hypocrisy, envy, and carping criticism.
Yes, rid yourself from all this.
Like newborn babies. All your longing should be for milk.
Yes, all your longing is for the milk. What is that milk?
The unadulterated spiritual milk.
Unadulterated spiritual milk. When we receive that unadulterated spiritual milk, that is Word of God. This Word can cure us, rescue from all the bondages. Again, sin. Paul says in 1 Corinthians chapter 3 verses 1 to 3.
And so, brothers, I was not able to talk to you as spiritual people. I had to talk to you as people still living by your natural inclinations.
Yes.
Still infants in Christ.
Still infants in Christ. What is the reason?
I fed you with milk and not solid food, for you are not yet able to take it. And even now you are still not able to. For you are still living by your natural inclinations.
And the Word of God, He is warning each one of us, for you are still living by your natural inclinations.
As long as there are jealousy and rivalry among you.
Yes, as long as there are jealousy and rivalry among you.
That surely means that you are still living by your natural inclinations.
Yes, still you are living by natural inclination.
And by merely human principles.
Yes.
While there is one that says, I belong to Paul, and another that says, I belong to Apollos.
So that's why we should cast out all jealousy, vanity, everything, and take the example of our Lord, how He humbled Himself. Philippians chapter 2, verses 1 to 5, we'll read.
So if in Christ there is anything that will move you, any incentive in love, any fellowship in the Spirit, any warmth or sympathy, I appeal to you, make my joy complete by being of a single mind, one in love, one in heart.
One in love, one in heart.
And one in mind.
Yes.
Nothing is to be done out of jealousy or vanity.
Nothing is to be done out of jealousy or vanity.
Instead, out of humility of mind, everyone should give preference to others.
Yes, this is the way we can conquer that evil. Give preference to others. Whenever others get something, we should rejoice in that. Otherwise, we should be like a people still living in this world with jealousy and all the kinds of sins. We should come out of that, never be enslaved by these kinds of sins, jealousy, vanity. Instead, we should grow in the grace and see how much our Lord loved. Lord has, how much generous He was. He has given His own life to each one of us. John chapter 3 verse 16 and 1 John chapter 3 verse 16, the great love. So this is what we are called for. Love our brothers and sisters. Complete love. Fully giving. That's what our Lord did. So we can conquer this evil through the practice of brotherly love. The next capital sin is wrath or anger. So we should, Ephesians chapter 4 verses 25 to 34.
So from now on, there must be no more lies.
There must be no more lies.
Speak the truth to one another, since we are all parts of one another. Even if you are angry, do not sin. Never let the sun set on your anger, or else you will give the devil a foothold. Anyone who was a thief must stop stealing. Instead, he should exert himself at some honest job with his own hands, so that he may have something to share with those in need. No foul word should ever cross your lips. Let your words be for the improvement of others, as occasion offers, and do good to your listeners.
And very often, devil tries to make us angry. So we should conquer this evil by patience. And one of the reflections of Saint John Mary Vianney, he says, this emotion, my children, comes from the devil. It shows that we are in his hands, that he is the master of our heart. When the anger comes, devil becomes the master of our heart. That he holds all the strings of it and make us dance as he please. See, a person who puts himself in a passion of it is like a puppet. He knows neither what he says nor what he does. The devil guides him entirely. He strikes right and left. His hair stands up like the bristle of a hedgehog. His eyes start out of his head. He is a scorpion, a furious lion. Why do we, my children, put ourselves into such a state? It is not pitiable. It is. So this is what is happening. We are putting ourselves into the devil's hand. So never be master of anger. Forgive. So we can conquer wrath by the practicing of meekness, humility. You know, Numbers chapter 12, verse 3. Moses, how God changed him. Numbers chapter 12, verse 3.
Now Moses was extremely humble, the humblest man on earth.
Yes, Moses became a humblest person of earth. Initial stage, he was also, he killed one person. So he was also like that, but God changed him and he became the most humble person of earth. So Lord can change us. So that's why we should give our life to our Lord. All our sins, never be mastered by evil, but conquer evil with good. Romans chapter 12, verses 21.
Do not be mastered by evil, but master evil with good.
Now master evil with good. Genesis chapter 4, verses 6 and 7. Always remember.
Yahweh asked Cain, why are you angry and downcast?
Yes, why are you angry and downcast? When the anger comes, the face will change.
If you are doing right, surely you ought to hold your head high. But if you are not doing right, sin is crouching at the door, hungry to get you.
Yes, if you are not doing the right, the sin is crouching at the door,
hungry to get you. You can still master him.
You can still master him. So we should do right and we should conquer evil. And again, the book of Sirach chapter 4, verse 29 says, 29 and 30.
Do not be bold of tongue, yet idle and slack indeed. Do not be like a lion at home or cowardly towards your servants.
Do not be like a lion at home. Sometimes we can see the people at home like a lion. So it should not be like that. Our Lord is giving us meekness. We should conquer the evil by doing good. And 1 Timothy chapter 2 verse 8, St. Paul says, when the anger comes, what we should do? 1 Timothy chapter 2 verse 8.
In every place then, I want the men to lift their hands up reverently in prayer.
We should lift up our hands, surrender to our Lord.
With no anger or argument.
Yes, no anger, no argument. Never give the opportunity for devil. If he get the opportunity, he will make use of us and he will destroy our life with the anger. That's why, especially if you meditate, Sirach chapter 28. And yesterday I was sharing how we should control our tongue. Because through tongues, many sins are entering into our family, in our society. James chapter 2, verses 1 to 12. We'll read some of the James chapter 3. James chapter 3, verses 1 to 12. We'll read from 2 onwards.
For we all trip up in many ways. Someone who does not trip up in speech has reached perfection and is able to keep...
If we want to reach in perfection, we should control our tongue.
And is able to keep the whole body on a tight rein.
Then he can or she can control the whole body.
Once we put a bit in the horse's mouth to make it do what we want, we have the whole animal under our control. Or think of ships. no matter how big they are, even if a gale is driving them, they are directed by a tiny rudder, wherever the whim of the helmsman decides. So the tongue is only a tiny part of the body.
And St. James says, so the tongue is only a tiny part of the body, but
its boasts are great.
Yes.
Think how small a flame can set fire to a huge forest.
A small fire can burn the entire forest. The same way, the tongue can poison the entire society.
The tongue is a flame too. Among all the parts of the body, the tongue is a whole wicked world.
And what St. James says is a whole wicked world.
It infects the whole body.
It infects the whole body. So if something comes from the tongue, it infects the body.
Catching fire itself from hell, it sets fire to the whole wheel of creation. Wild animals and birds, reptiles and fish of every kind can all be tamed and have been tamed by humans.
Yes, we have tamed everything, or elephant or any animals we can tame. But
nobody can tame the tongue. It is a pest that will not keep still.
It is a pest that will not keep still.
Full of deadly poison.
Full of deadly poison. That's what our tongue is. If you're not controlling the tongue, what will happen? This poison will come out from our tongue.
We use it to bless the Lord and Father, but we also use it to curse people who are
made in
God's
image. That's why, my dear brothers and sisters, we never use this tongue to curse our brothers and sisters, created in our own images, in God's images and likeness.
The blessing and curse come out of the same mouth. My brothers, this must be wrong.
This must be wrong.
Does any water supply give a flow of fresh water and salt water out of the same pipe? Can a fig tree yield olives, my brothers, or a vine yield figs? No more can sea water yield fresh water.
Yes, in order to control the tongues, we should especially read the Psalms. Psalm 56 and 62 and 68. And you can note down all these verses. And Sirach 28, full chapter. And these whole verses will give us strength and will teach us how to control our tongue, how we should be in our speeches, how the word should come. 1 Peter chapter 3, verses 15 and 16 we shared yesterday, how we should reply with courtesy and respect. Our word should come with courtesy and respect, and we should respect each other. That's the way we can conquer. Because we should understand all these evil are rooted in the human heart. Matthew chapter 12, verses 33 to 37.
Make a tree sound and its fruit will be sound. Make a tree rotten and its fruit will be rotten. For the tree can be told by its fruit. You brood of vipers, how can your speech be good when you are evil? For words flow out of what fills the heart.
So the solution is we should clean our heart. Mark chapter 7 verses 20 to 23 says, something coming from within us that make the person unclean. Mark chapter 7 verses 20 to 23.
And he went on, it is what comes out of someone that makes that person unclean. For it is from within, from the heart, that evil intentions emerge. Fornication, theft, murder, adultery, avarice, malice, deceit, indecency, envy, slander, pride, folly. All these evil things come from within and make a person unclean.
And the other capital sins are the lust. Matthew chapter 5 verses 27 to 30.
You have heard how it was said, you shall not commit adultery. But I say this to you, if a man looks at a woman lustfully, he has already committed adultery with her in his heart.
Yes, we should control ourselves, self-control. We should pray. Sirach chapter 23 verses 1 to 6, prayer for the self-control. And we should conquer lust through the practice of chastity. We should lead a holy life. That is what our goal is. we shared yesterday some of the Word of God. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verses 3 to 7. We can write that word again. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verses 3 to 7. Our Lord has called each one of us to lead a holy life. So we should, and we'll be having a section about holiness and humility. And the other sin is gluttony, excessive, uncontrolled preoccupation with food and drink. We should. Philippians chapter 3, verse 19 says, their God is their belly. Philippians 3, 19.
They are destined to be lost. Their God is the stomach.
Yeah, their God is their stomach. Always thinking about food.
They glory in what they should think shameful.
That's why St. Paul says, the Word of God says in Hebrews chapter 13, verses 9.
Do not be led astray by all sorts of strange doctrines.
9 and 10, yes.
It is better to rely on grace for inner strength than on food, which has done no good to those who concentrate on it.
Yes, we should be moderate in everything. And when the Holy Spirit comes, the Holy Spirit will teach us. And again, the capital sin is sloth. Very often, we are like Proverbs chapter 6, verses 6 to 12. We listen to that.
Idler, go to the ant, ponder her ways.
And especially if you get time, you should read especially Proverbs and Sirach. And many verses are there. Due to the shorter of time, I cannot share all the verses. So how we should conquer all these kinds of evil in our life. And the proverb saying,
idler, go to the ant.
Idler, go to an ant.
Ponder her ways and grow wise.
Yes.
No one gives her orders, no overseer, no master.
No one gives order, no master. But how ants are working. In our life, someone has to push or to do something. Always, we are not ready to do. Pray. We are not able to pray because of laziness. We should not be like that. We should not be mastered by these kinds of evil. We should master evil with good. So that's what the Word of God says. Learn from an ant.
No one gives her orders, no overseer, no master. Yet all through the summer, she gets her food ready.
Yes.
And gathers her supplies at harvest.
In our spiritual life too, we all need discipline. Because if you are leading undisciplined life, we cannot be a spiritual person. We need prayer. We need scripture readings. We need constant support, spiritual support. We need sacraments. All should be in order. 1 Corinthians chapter 14, verse 40. Everything should be done in an orderly manner. So then we will. That's why we should get up early morning and pray. We will experience the God's mercy. Wisdom chapter 16, verses 25 to 27. When we pray in the morning, we will get grace from our Lord.
And this is why, by changing into all things, it obediently served your all-nourishing bounty, conforming to the wishes of those who were in need. So that your beloved children, Lord, might learn that the various crops are not what provide nourishment, but your word, which preserves all who believe in you. For that which fire could not destroy melted in the heat of a single fleeting sunbeam, to show that to give you thanks, we must rise before the sun and meet you.
And the Word of God is, we must rise before the sun
and meet you at the dawning of the day.
Yes. Sirach chapter 39 or so, 1 to 5. The upright people will get up in the morning and praise God, and they will start the day with prayer. So through the prayer, we can conquer all the evil. So we should, and through the Word of God, by the power of the Word of God, by reading the Scriptures. So let us, for a moment, close our eyes, my dear brothers and sisters.